I went vegan as I get more mature and feel the effects of the change of the diet on my body and my social circle and my community and then the environment. It's just become like this really karmic point in my life where I am a no for all the danger arts that I really do, all the violence that I do in my movement and my artistic art forms. I really am a non-violent person. Like, there's no killing. There's absolutely no killing karma or death karma intended in my life. 7.5 years ago, I went raw vegan because I decided that one of the animals that I wanted to take care of was indeed the human animal, and myself being that as well. So raw veganism was the next natural step for that no-death karma. And the beautiful thing is, of course, the environment prospers, endangered species prosper, like the individual animal prospers. So when you're raw vegan, just so you know, you're not really eating packaged foods and you're not shipping things from around the world to get to you. And that's one of the main concerns about the species extinction and threatened species is the lack of land and the resources that humans are taking up. So I'm kind of working on a global level here, trying to protect everything all at once. And it seems to be all wrapped up into the raw vegan diet. Now, I was turned on to Bold Native through a fellow vegan activist who sent me a script. He said, "I think you need to take a look at this. This is a project that other vegan actors need to know about, and this production company needs to know about vegan actors." And I read the script and I cried. And just so you
I
know,
cry I
over.
cry watching the trailer, so I don't know.
Oh, wow. It's touching. And I feel that I'm an artist, and I feel that truly art has more influence in human consciousness globally than politics, than anything else we do, because the world digests our media. We are sitting in such a fortunate place in Los Angeles, Hollywood, California, the epicenter of media production, and Open Road Films has taken that the opportunity. Not people don't see this opportunity often enough. Open Road Films has taken this opportunity to know that art really does have a global voice. And because people watch it as a story with characters, they invest more. They don't draw, you know, judgments. They just allow themselves to be taken on a journey that they would otherwise, "Oh, I'm not reading that in the newspaper. That's not my issue. You know, I'm not interested in that candidate or what's going on in my local elections or whatnot." They're not interested because it's not a story. So Open Road Films has really embraced the power of art to take people on a journey, and that's where I come in. I heard that they were giving preferential treatment or trying, not preferential treatment, but trying actively to get activists or people to speak out and write, or who are just knowledgeable on the subject, into the film. And when I met Casey and Dennis, I auditioned, sure, I read, but I also was interviewed. It was kind of like I had to prove to them how into the movement I was. And after filming the film, I am so glad that was the case, because the film is filled with people who know what's going on in the movement, with people who care. And I read the script 7 more times. During my breakdown of the script and my analysis and my little actor things that I do, and I cried every single time. It never changed. And that's the touching film that we've created to give to other people. And vegans out there, please, like, we want to come to your town. Make it happen. Like, this is your activism. Bring this movie to your town, because you need to see it, and other your friends need to see it to go with you. The whole community needs to see it, and it's a wonderful story. There is no mom or dad who's not into an issue that's going to be against seeing this wonderful story. So that's where I came in. I was originally, can I confess, reading for one of the lead female roles, and I didn't, for whatever reason, you know, acting fit that part. And Open Road Films is so open-minded, they still wanted to keep my voice and my talent in the film. They Comfort Me Your World, it was originally written for a guy. And that is another social issue. Like, in the industry, that's a really beautiful thing, that these people are so open-minded that I, of course, was absolutely appropriately cast as this character. And maybe the character was written for the wrong, as the wrong gender, because it definitely was expressed, you know, appropriately through my gender.
Mm-hmm.
I talked about my journey through to raw veganism. I talked about the books that I write, you know, the raw nutritional analysis. I speak at festivals. I have a lot of passion, if you can't tell. And I talked about the volunteer work that I've done with endangered species and philanthropy and how we need to donate to organizations that are organizing and carrying on the cause. There's so many ways that we can be activists. And the first and foremost, of course, is changing your diet. Like, that's something you can do at home, and you don't need permission, and it doesn't cost you any money. It can be as cheap as you want it to be.
And so, you can do it. And you can do it today. You don't have to wait for the government to, you know, sign a treaty or anything. You know, you can do that action today. So, who wants to give us a brief minute and a half synopsis of the story of the film? I don't know if we really have gotten that. What's the story behind Bold Native?
Hey, so you want to do that?
No, I would actually like to hear Tanya describe it. All the time, you know. I want to hear your one sentence pitch.
Oh, thank you. That's really exciting because I'm totally on the spot. Like, the writers are sitting in front of me listening to me. Okay. Bold Native is a film about animal activists wanted for terrorism by the FBI, and an estranged father and son relationship in turmoil, trying to now reunite a race, the father's race, to see who can get to his estranged son first, the FBI or him, to try and mend the wounds of the past.
That's pretty good. And, you know, we're also following a woman who works for a, humane welfare organization, trying to make change within the system through, you know, lobbying. And then, you know, we're also following, as you said, of, you know, ALF, essentially ALF-type individuals as they're putting together a nationwide action. But there's multiple storylines going on. Tanya comes in as the sort of sidekick, vagabond, spirit, crazy guide that helps the father along his journey of trying to find his son.
I am not the destination. I am the vehicle.
That's exactly right.
Okay. All right. And the website for the film, and any websites you'd like people to visit. And also, if anybody, you know, I mean, people listen to the show worldwide, people can contact me, bob@goveganradio.com, or I have a Facebook page. And if they're interested in screenings, I'll pass the information on to the filmmakers. We'll see what we can do. I'm happy to work with you on trying to arrange for screenings with various events with which I work, too. So.
That'd be great. I mean, the website is boldnative.com, BoldNative, boldnative.com. We also have a Facebook page. You can email us at info@boldnative.com. Some people have offered, you know, and we're working to try to get the film internationally as much as we can. We've had some offers to help us set up screenings. If you haven't heard back from us yet and you've made one, I assure you, you're on our list, and we will be getting back to you as soon as we get to that point. Right now, we're just trying to get everything ready for the LA premiere. But yeah, you can contact us through the Facebook or info@boldnative.com if you want to help out.
Okay, and tell us about the LA premiere again. When, where, what, why, how?
That's June 16th, Wednesday, at the Majestic Crest Theater in Westwood, and then June 18th at Tree People. There's info on both screenings at the website on the screenings page of boldnative.com.
Okay. And Tanya, you have a website. Should people visit your website for any reason? If they need a danger artist who's vegan, so she has the energy to do. And a danger artist, quickly, like in 30 seconds, Tanya, what is a danger artist to? What are your dangers?
A danger artist is somebody who loves movement so much that they will stop at nothing to know the extent that movement can go to. I throw knives. I crack bullwhips, I spin fire, I grind sparks off of my body with a metal grinder. I stilt dance, I flag dance. It's given me all sorts of performance opportunities and really amazing venues throughout my life.
He just calls that his Friday night out. He doesn't call it danger art.